Very few people have the ability to fire up our imaginations and make us think about the human condition. Gene Roddenberry, the creator of Star Trek, was one of those people. He took us where no man has gone before and beyond. He created a starship, its crew, an entire universe, and brought them to life for millions of people. Without Gene, there would have been no Star Trek television series or a Star Trek computer series. Gene Roddenberry, born 1921, died 1991. We honor your memory.
But I say to you, our greatest challenge is not the might of a Klingon fleet.
And they all wanted one thing.
The greatest challenge laying before us is to do what must be done without undoing the dream of the Federation.
Hope.
For myself, I have but one fear. Destroying the dream of the Federation. Compared to such a loss, I do not fear the Klingon Empire!
It was a good speech.
Until I heard Admiral Ramirez speak. I had not foreseen the possibility of a peace between the Federation and the Klingons. Nor had I foreseen the possibility that the Federation might win.
It is a numbers game. Your people for mine. Your union for my empire. It is as simple as that.
Discovery, come in.
Discovery here, Captain.
Carry out your orders. One way or another, this ends here.
Where did he go?
Francis, load the photonic torpedoes.
Yes, sir.
Target the tower.
Loaded and ready, sir.
Tamar, you think you can handle getting us in without burning up the atmosphere?
Where is he?
He's above us.
That can't be good.
Power's being shunted to that station.
I can only hope they've received the message.
I'm going to assume they did. They still have 2 minutes. Hold fast, Lieutenant.
Jennifer? Jennifer,
this is Dale. If you can hear this, please hurry.
You've only got 2 minutes until... Remember our date? I've got the wine cooling. Please!
Structural integrity is at 30%.
Our makeshift repairs won't last forever.
Radiation levels are critical. Hurry.
The Voron field is dispersed, Captain. She's gone.
Why did you steer us away?
I've had no choice. Look at these readings. If we returned, our radiation leak interacting with Borons could easily have triggered a chain reaction in your atmosphere. We would have killed everything on the surface.
Then the final chapter can never be read. It's over.
Maybe not. I have an idea.
Captain, we've lost impulse power.
Maneuvering thrusters, Lieutenant Foster. Hold your course.
Aye, sir.
Engineering, Menard, I need impulse power now.
Word from Dr. Floyd. The captain's dead.
Captain, another Sukulon warship is closing in. They're firing.
Cannon, I need weapons.
Get us out of here!
Way ahead of you.
We can match the harmonics and pull out.
We tried that. Warp drive accelerates the planet's breakup.
Impulse, then. I recommend full impulse.
Help. Full impulse, best escape vector.
We can't break free on impulse.
Raider?
There has to be a gravity differential or something.
Captain, look!
Red alert!
All hands, this is DXO, General Carter's main station population.
Hull polarized, shields up, phasers online.
Helm, point our nose into the debris.
10 seconds to impact.
Our shields can handle this, right?
All hands, brace for impact.
They're up! I don't know what's happening!
Phasers, fire at will!
There's a problem with the reactor. There's not enough power.
You are hereby relieved of command.
Let go of me! Do you realize what you're doing?
I do.
You're a coward, Spock. You don't even have the guts to execute us like a real leader.
This shuttlecraft is at your disposal. I recommend setting a course to the nearest habitable system. You have sufficient supplies to last until then.
You think that changes anything? So you've taken control of one ship, so what? What now?
Peace. Freedom.
The Empire will hunt you down like the mangy dog that you are.
Perhaps. But I must try.
You
won't get away with this, Spock. You're just one man.
In every revolution, there is one man with a vision.
Who told you that?
You did.
Commander, status report.
All decks reporting in, Captain. The Hulk and survivors are safely on board.
Shuttlecraft Galileo is leaving sensor range.
James T. Kirk chose his path. It is time we chose ours. Warp 2, Ensign.
Heading, sir.
Forward.
He knows the mission. I don't.
We'll be in orbit in 30 minutes, Captain.
Thank you.
Take us to these coordinates.
I recognize these. It's a Debrun ruin. At least, I think it is. I haven't had a chance to take a closer look.
You've turned my ship upside down for an archaeological expedition.
If you hadn't got in my way, I wouldn't have had to turn your ship in any direction.
Captain Picard, my ready room, now. I get the feeling we're not going to like each other.
I get the feeling you don't like many people, Captain.
You refuse to identify yourself. You fired on a planet under my protection.
Oh yes, your protection. I've seen what comes of your protection.
What's that supposed to mean?
I first encountered Loran Talath in a joint operation with the Hiroshima. She was a remarkable woman and a fine captain. She deserved better.
You weren't there.
I read the report.
Anyone can second guess.
At 1 minute 50 seconds, you ordered a tractor beam, which failed.
At 2 minutes 15 seconds, you attempted another tractor beam, which your own science officer told you wouldn't work.
And you'd have done something different, I suppose.
The great Jean-Luc Picard would have changed the laws of physics.
Oh no. I'd have obeyed them. All you needed to do was change the trajectory by 19 degrees, and the ship would have skipped off the planet's atmosphere.
There wasn't time to...
Tell me, Mr. Hunter, what did you order first? The tractor beam or the torpedo lock? If there's nothing else, Captain.
I was born to the Vulcan Sarek and to the human Amanda Grayson. Being half Vulcan and half human, I was not fully accepted in my culture. So Vulcan is my homeworld. I was treated as an off-worlder. Here, I was not Vulcan enough. To humanity, I was an alien. I tried to suppress my emotion, but it is always there. Pain, loneliness. To understand the universe, to deal with it, I started logic and science. I found music calming and found satisfaction in problem solving. In art, I found meaning. In my journey, I have endured both struggles and delight. It is through Starfleet I have found acceptance, purpose, and friendship. It is here, on this ship, with these people, I have found a home, a place I belong. I am Spock.
Jakande! Kane, status on comms.
Communications relay overload, Captain. I'm rerouting now, just give me a minute.
Franklin, damage report.
Hull breach on deck 6, emergency bulkheads in place. Phaser banks 3 and 4 damaged, auxiliary control circuits temporarily disabled. Casualties.
Go ahead, Doctor.
Captain, I have Ramirez in sickbay. He's been hit. He's in critical condition. I need to operate, but I can't while the ship is being blasted apart.
Understood.
The ship gets blasted apart. It's not going to matter. Kane, I need comms now.
Thanks for calling me back. I thought you'd hung up on me.
Ramirez is in sickbay. He's critical.
Get out of here, Garth. Now. We'll handle this.
Jump to war with us. With any luck, we can both make it back to the fleet.
No. Engineering, can you confirm? Those D-7s are faster than us. Starfleet can't afford to lose both our ships plus Ramirez. We'll handle the battle cruisers. Helm, come about.
Jakande, no. We'll beam Ramirez to you. We can lower our ventral shield just long enough to get...
Captain, we've just taken heavy damage to the ventral power conduits. It's knocked out the transporters.
Damn it. Jakande, can you beam Ramirez?
Our transporters are out too. Garth, this is the only way. You've got to get Ramirez out of here now. Engineering, slow to 1/4 impulse, start venting warp plasma. We've got to make it seem like we've been crippled.
Yes, Captain.
And Commander, be prepared to shut down antimatter containment. On my mark.
But Captain, that'll destroy the ship.
I know.
Aye, sir.
Jakande.
It's been an honor serving with you, Captain Garth. Now get the hell out of here.
The honor is ours, Artemis.
Helm, hard about.
Helm, Warp Factor 7. Now.
Engineering, shut down antimatter containment unit. Now.
Identify yourself.
This is Commander Robert Tackett of the Federation Starship Farragut.
Ah, Commander Tackett.
And you are?
Your conqueror. Surrender and prepare to be boarded.
That's funny. I was about to say the same thing.
You have violated treaty and illegally entered the neutral zone. If you do not surrender your vessel immediately...
We have evidence of a Romulan vessel in Federation territory, which has collided with one of our ships. Clearly an act of war.
I deny knowledge of any such act. Clearly it was...
Unintentional?
Accidental.
We are on a rescue mission to recover any survivors from the Federation vessel.
There are no survivors on that planet, Commander. Remove yourself from this star system immediately.
You know I can't do that.
And you know I cannot allow you to live. You have been a worthy adversary, Commander.
So your plan was to antagonize her?
Mr. Logan, set a course for a close orbit of the Red Giant Star.
How close in orbit, sir?
500,000 kilometers.
Are you serious? That's inside the star's corona. Without shields, we can't take the heat from that star for even a few moments. And the solar winds will pummel the Farragut with radiation.
We only need a few moments.
The solar wind.
I still don't understand.
We can't get the Romulans to decloak, but we can see the solar wind.
When the Romulans follow us into the path of the solar wind...
And you made sure they'd do that.
We utilize our sensors to target where the displacement.
And we shoot at their wake. In our current condition, we'll only have one shot at this.
Sensors ready, sir.
Mike?
Phasers and photon torpedoes ready, sir.
Tie in the weapons targeting from Mr. Jalen's computer.
Aye, sir.
I'm detecting a wake, 5,000 kilometers aft.
Spin us around 180 degrees, full impulse. Mr. Jones, target weapons and engines only.
Aye.
All weapons, fire!
To get out of here.
Mr. Logan, best possible speed out of Star's Corona.
Aye, sir.
Mr. Jalen, tractor beam.
Nexotox, Stover Corps. Commander Stover. G.I.s.
Commander, the Klingon ship is about to fire.
Full power to shields now.
Sir, there's another ship coming in.
How the hell does this happen?
You need to lower your voice.
You need to explain yourself. You took a commission without discussing it with me.
I tried to discuss it with you many times, but you shut me out.
I shut you? I never shut it.
Yes,
I never
you
shut
did,
you. I never
Robert.
Know such thing.
My bags have been packed for days. Did you not notice? Or did you not care?
Of course I care. That's a...
You have a funny way of showing it.
That is low.
And I apologize.
Were you planning on telling me?
I was going to tell you. I tried to tell you. You don't listen to anything.
Well, I'm sorry my life has become a burden to you, Sarah.
That was low. I've tried to help you. I've tried to be there for you, and in truth, I still am. I know you're going through some things that...
Things don't quite...
But
covered.
I have a life, too. I have a career, too. And I'm not going to sit around and wait for you to make up your mind. I have to do what's best for us, and I have to do what's best for me.
I was staying on Earth for you!
You were staying on Earth for yourself. Because you were scared, and you have every right to be. But don't delude yourself on the reasoning.
I cannot protect you up here.
I am a Starfleet officer. You don't need to protect me.
You want to talk? Let's talk. No, I'm here right now, so let's talk through this. What do you want to hear? What do you want to hear? You want to hear that I am broken? There you go. That I messed things up. I know I did. I am not the man I once was, and I have no idea how to be that again.
Yes.
You're needed in SickBay, Doctor.
I'm on my way. Permission to be dismissed, Captain.
Preparing to shunt the power.
What's wrong?
Do you remember that bulkhead? The one that sealed me in this section.
What about it?
The power in this box is the only thing keeping the magnetic seals in place. On the other side of this bulkhead is a hull breach.
Forget it then. Look, I'm gonna sever this comlink.
Maybe someone had the same idea as you did, they may be trying to get through.
Time till we reach the minefield?
Long enough.
Don't lie to me when I'm about to die. It's not very polite.
This isn't funny.
Neither is the minefield. This is the only way.
I'm cutting this line. Hang tight.
That's an order.
Please don't leave me. Not now.
You don't have to go through with this.
Time till impact?
20 seconds. You don't have to throw your life away.
How does the saying go? Needs of the many?
Oh, don't give me that crap. We don't even know how many people are still alive.
I'm doing something clever.
It's my job, remember?
Thinking outside the box. Never pictured myself dying in a hull breach.
Elizabeth.
Thank you, Ben.
For what?
For not hanging up on me. Good chat.
He needs help!
I'm a freedom fighter, not a doctor.
You're also a human being, damn it.
Locking down these controls is more important.
Oh, too far.
The prisoners have taken over auxiliary engineering control. One is believed dead.
Well, what are you standing there for? Get in there and regain control of my ship.
It won't be that easy. They've erected a force field around the control room and isolated several key systems.
Get them out! I don't care if you have to blast through the bulkheads. Am I clear?
Are you finished?
Almost.
Auto-destruct sequence initiated.
What are you doing? What has to be done?
What about the mission?
I'm changing the mission.
Kittrick!
You knew this was a one-way trip.
Auto-destruct was the last resort. We control the ship. There's still time.
Auto-destruct in 45 seconds.
Kittrick!
Stand down!
Override has been disabled.
How did he do this?
I don't know.
Auto-destruct in 30 seconds.
Kittrick!
What do you want?
I want nothing.
You wouldn't be threatening to blow up my ship if you didn't want something.
Auto-destruct in 15 seconds.
What do you want?
I want you to die.
Auto-destruct in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2...
Do you realize what you've done?
Yes. Given us a chance to gain freedom for everyone.
This was the only way.
How does killing all of us relate to freedom?
These people must be stopped. They're murderers and butchers. They deserve to die.
Tuvok and I are not murderers. We've done nothing to deserve death.
And what have you done to deserve life? You hide behind your righteous pacifism while others die fighting for their freedom!
Not everyone fights by killing and blowing up starships.
I kill when it is necessary.
What about peace and non-interference? Are they not necessary?
I thought so once. Not anymore.
Trilithium must have spiked. Not enough to take out the containment, but the feedback must have knocked out main power.
We're losing containment. It's just a matter of where. Gotta limit the damage. We cannot let this boat hit the starbase.
Cycling secondary power.
Attempting manual restart of impulse engines.
Starbase Control, this is Shuttle Avalon, Mayday.
We have a catastrophic failure of our impulse engines and trilithium containment.
Request emergency beam out for two passengers.
Shuttle Avalon, this is Starbase Control. Have you tried a manual restart of the onboard reactor? If you can stabilize containment, we can tractor you in.
Not enough time. We can't risk a collision with the Starbase with trilithium aboard. If I reroute power from life support and the containment field, I can probably get Avalon outside the base's shields before the cargo explodes.
Mason, I can fix it. I just need more time.
Time is exactly the one thing we don't have. And power. And options. Okay, there's a lot of things we don't have, and time is one of them.
Can you engage autopilot?
Autopilot is a no-go. It's manual thrusters from here on out.
Get a pattern lock on all of them.
Negative!
I need to remain in control of this craft.
You can't fix it for me this time, Beck.
It's up to me now.
Derek, Shuttle Avalon. Situation understood. Emergency protocol's in effect.
I can't get a lock on them. There's too much interference.
We're having trouble isolating your individual life signs through the radiation. You'll have to activate your emergency beacon on your tricorder to give us something to lock onto.
Copy, Starbase Control. Sure you want to do this? I can pilot the shuttle. I mean, at least we should flip a coin. It's my command and my decision. Go.
Commander, we have to go.
I just need more time.
It's an order, Commander.
And it's final.
I have a lock.
Shuttle Avalon, we have a positive signal and a lock. Stand by for transport.
Amanda. Energize. Diverting life support to thrusters. Here we go, one last big push. You can do this.
Containment failure. Imminent.
Lance, I couldn't get him out.
Jak je na tom Luanda?
Minimální škody, admirále. Má pouze oslabené horní štíty.
Spojte mě s Nukem.
Admirále.
Jak jste na tom, kapitáne?
Špatně, pane. Přišli jsme o všechny zbraňové systémy a máme ztráty skoro na všech palubách. Štíty jsme obnovili, ale nevím, jak dlouho vydrží.
Minneapolis má zbraně funkční, ale jsme bez pohonu a téměř bez štítů. Jsme první na ráně, až se otočí.
Budeme vás krýt, admirále.
Ne, to nechci. Máte funkční pohon?
Ano. Pohon je asi jediná věc, za kterou se můžu stoprocentně zaručit.
Admirále, Luanda se obrací.
Nemáme čas. Kapitáne, mám pro vás úkol.
Otáčíme se, budeme v dostřelu za 30 sekund.
Soustřeďte palbu na vlajkovou loď. Vidíte, kapitáne? Válku vedou lidé a ne stroje. Kvůli vám se pokusili Luandu jen ochromit. A to jim přinese zkázu.
Ta druhá loď se staví mezi nás a vlajkovou loď.
Pochopitelně. Chrání svého admirála. Palte dle uvážení.
Kapitáne DeSantisi?
Ano, pane.
Zaměřte torpéda na nuk a palte.
Na nuk, pane.
Splňte ten rozkaz nadporučíku.
Dělají. Proč na nás nestřílejí?
Zřejmě nemohou, ale blokují nám zaměření na svou vlajkovou loď.
Nebo jen možná pochopili, v jaké jsou krajině.
Krajině?
To nevíte, jak Sun Tzu popsal devatero krajin? Rozptilující sluje krajina,
jenž rozptiluje síly vladaře, co ve vlastní zemi bojuje.
Převádíme energii do přední štítu.
Nepřátelská loď se obrací.
Smrtonosnou sluje krajina, v níž jen bezprostřední boj nás může zachránit, neb jinak jsme v ní ztraceni.
Další takový zásah nevydržíme.
Ještě pár sekund.
Ve smrtonosné krajině bojuj.
Teď!
Execute Garth maneuver in 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Execute!
Engineering hull, all systems green.
All right, Mr. Sulu, track to that ship. Hold her steady.
Aye, sir. Engaging tractor beam now.
The alien ship is unable to maneuver away.
Aye, Mr. Kyle. Good work, Mr. Sulu. Now, Jakarl, all phasers. Fire.
Firing, sir.
Tractor circuits beginning to overheat.
Engage secondary circuits.
Maintain full phaser fire.
Increase power to tractor beam.
Panel, navigator, max speed out of the area.
Approaching second buoy.
Finally.
Passing marker buoy.
Scott to engineering hull. Prepare to dock.
Sulu here. Aye, sir. Commencing approach maneuver.
Ah, Mr. Sulu. Good work, lad. You'll make a fine captain one day.
One day?
He's Jim's protege, all right.
Sir, sensors detect a ship ahead.
Red alert. That same ship again.
No, sir. A different vessel. But similar design. A larger ship. Perhaps from the same civilization.
Maintain alert status.
It's the Archer. They're hailing us.
Hear what they have to say.
This is Captain Alvarez, the Federation Starship Archer. You are hereby ordered to stand down and answer to the charges of hijacking a Federation shipment of dilithium crystals. Am I clear?
Open the channel.
Alexa Singh.
Captain Alvarez.
This is definitely a surprise. You're supposed to be serving out a life sentence in an Orion prison right now.
Oh, I'm afraid you've been misinformed, Captain.
You happen to be a convicted criminal. If I bring you in, I guarantee to get a medal.
We're in neutral space, and you're out of your jurisdiction.
We'll see about that. Battle stations.
Battle stations.
Let's see how you handle this.
Return fire.
Program another spread, now!
I'm not letting them get away.
Take them down.
Approaching the Siphon system.
Time?
Less than a minute.
Rear photons.
We will burn the universe in our wake.
Only enough to slow them down.
Shields are holding.
Fire!
We're nearing restricted space.
We almost got him.
Diplomatic relations have been severed. We're forbidden to enter the sector.
No one fires on my ship and gets away.
Second, sir.
Captain!
Belay that! Let him go. Damn it.
You question my honor!
Nothing honorable about this, Klingon. This isn't about skills, it's about money. If our captors could do this, they wouldn't need us. We're the most valuable people in this prison, and we need to work together.
You preach too much, human. I will slay you as easily as I did your pathetic Patak.
You're an old. You've gotten lazy fighting those who are weaker than you. Fight those who are worth victory over. Those who have no honor.
I'd rather die than fight alongside you.
Then you'll die a puppet, damn for eternity.
Get out of the way.
Captain's log. I am really uncomfortable saying that. The entire crew, save myself and Captain Kirk, have beamed down to the surface of the planet Omicron SETI 3. A landing party was sent down to the planet earlier and brought back these weird spores, although not like the last time with the dancing and the touching. That was horrible. These new spores apparently just make you really, really happy and then abandon ship. I wasn't affected because I've been in my quarters all week due to a reaction to some particles brought on board from Mia 3. So now, as acting captain, I think, I am helping Captain Kirk fly the Enterprise. Yeah, it's as terrifying as it sounds.
Kirk to Williams.
Ensign Williams here, Captain.
Release the command lockout on propulsion.
Aye, aye, sir.
Cancel, red alert.
Yes, Captain. Blue alert? What the hell is that?
Cancel blue alert!
Yes, Captain! I didn't even know that was possible. I'm just gonna start mashing buttons, Captain. So that's what he's always looking at.
Ensign.
Yes, Captain.
I want you to override the bridge navigation system and plot a course for Starbase 11.
Yes, Captain.
Did you just fire the ship's phasers?
Yes, Captain.
Ensign, execute navigation sequence B and free us from orbit.
This, and that.
Stop firing the weapons!
Damn it, Captain, I'm a security officer, not a pilot!
Ensign, I am about to engage the impulse nacelles, which has let us break free of orbit as long as you keep a steady hand on the helm.
Okay. Are you sure?
Trust your abilities, Ensign. Engaging. Engines. Now! Push the big red button, Ensign. The big red button!
Oh. I guess I don't need to do that anymore.
Let's try again, Ensign.
Captain, did you put a plant on the bridge? Captain Kirk, I love you. And Dr. McCoy. And the ship. Oh, it's so pretty.
Captain Slog, supplemental. After some fast talking, Dr. McGruff and I were able to convince Tapoodle that our intentions were well-meaning. She agreed to allow us to remain, but refused to waive our fines for not going through Vulcanine customs.
Now begins the ceremony. The beginning of the ceremony is now. We know this is the beginning, because it hasn't happened yet. Long ago, our ancestors talked about the beginning, because they were there in the beginning. Not this beginning, the other beginning, the big beginning, not this one. They talked of the beginning because they could not talk about the ending. They couldn't even talk about the middle part. They was in the beginning, you see.
Typical.
The Pomeranian has clearly chosen the challenge spot. You will have to fight him for her. Do you understand these terms, Captain Croc? You must fight spot for her.
Righto. Gotcha. Coming through loud and clear.
A fight to the death. A horrible struggle pitting a friend against friend.
Absolutely. On the same bench. Whatever you say.
Then let the combat begin.
Well, who said anything about combat? Don't I get a sash? What is this for? Is this supposed to be some kind of weapon? Hey, my shirt!
Do you have any idea how difficult it is to repair velour? You realize, of course, that this means war.
If you insist, Captain.
Combat will continue with the dog Chew.
Gesundheit.
Open Klingon style. Klingon style. Kawan Rotar, Ikusaka Blajita. Yuridatu, Chakalea, Kuku, Gerbin, Bajamau, Nuhosta. Ooh. Klingon style. Klingon style. Open Klingon style. Klingon style. Open Klingon style.
Federation Council.
Insolence will not be tolerated!
Defense status. Hit on starboard warp pod. We return fire.
Negative. Too much sensor interference.
Time.
Aye, sir!
transporter's been activated.
Lieutenant, get us out of here.
Captain, the starbase is reaching critical mass. Its destruction is imminent.
Target the runabout and lock on a tractor beam. Try and pull them out of there.
It's no use, sir. There's too much interference coming from the nebula.
Ma'am, we've been able to establish partial communication with the runabout.
Hail them, Commander.
USS Blaster, this is the USS Kemp. Request immediate assistance. Lieutenant Edwards is dead. Our engines are failing and life support is critical. I repeat, request immediate assistance.
Captain. At its current speed, the runabout will not be able to escape the explosion in time.
Bridge to transporter room 2. Log on to USS Thames and beam Lieutenant Miller aboard.
I'm trying, sir, but there's a lot of interference.
Keep trying.
Sir, the starbase.
This is General Korloth. Of the commanders of the Imperial Klingon forces in this sector. What is your business so close to our space, Starfleet?
General, I'm Commander Loomis of the Hood. We've discovered a wormhole to a distant galaxy in this nebula. There's a hostile ship pursuing us. Recommend you withdraw.
Withdraw? Ha ha ha! Our Klingon faces his enemies, Commander. It is they who will withdraw or die. You should not have violated our space, Commander. But we will settle this later. But now, we have what it is you humans say. Oh yes, bigger fish to fry.
He's coming. He's close. He's adapting!
Nektas. It's right around here somewhere. I know it.
There it is.
What do we do?
I'll lure it away and you get the plant.
You can't outrun that thing.
You should have seen my high school track meets.
I did. Son.
Now!
Here! Here, Romulus 3!
At the rate this thing's going, we don't have long. Helm, increase speed. Deflector on my mark. Full power. Now!
Shields down to 43%.
The Taya?
I think it's working.
You think?
Massive sensor interference, but my gut says it's working.
It's working, but not completely. Think, Anna, think! What am I missing? Keely to Intrepid, I know how we can make it work. We need to use the remaining particles left on our hulls. It's the catalyst, the key.
Shields at 27%.
Divert power to aft shields. Whatever you're gonna do, do it fast.
I've used a quantic vibration matrix to draw the remaining particles into a focused beam.
I've only got one shot at this. I've got to get close. Good luck, Captain.
She's going in. Oh, damn it, Keely, it's not a race. Start vibration matrix and send out a new pulse.
Already calibrated. Ready to fire.
Helm, take us in. Fire particle beam.
Where am I?
You make it through in one piece, Lieutenant?
Well, at first glance, I'm alive. I'll have to send you a full report once I know more, of course. I take it this is Charon Station?
Welcome to my home away from home. And a long way from yours. Horizon will be wondering what happened.
Scout to Enterprise! The reactors are critical!
Sir, there's nothing I can do! Can you jettison the core?
Circuits are fused.
How much time?
Minutes. Seconds. Impossible to tell. I'm sorry.
Enterprise. Get as far away as possible. Rendezvous with the Captain at Corn 4.
Commander?
Lieutenant, that's a direct order.
Yes, sir.
Wait!
I have an idea. Permission to take weapon subsystem station, sir. Trust me.
Go.
Enterprise, get out of here! Mr. Hadley, that's a direct order!
Chekhov.
I might be able to transmit to Tronic algorithm. Overload signal gain. Force computer to drop shields.
Are you daft? That'll show down the whole board. You'll kill yourself, man!
The Hood's warp core is critical!
Glazoboyatsya, Haruki, Yariut.
The shields are down. Transporter room, get them out of there!
Permission to speak candidly, Captain.
By all means.
He's right, sir. That boy's father is going to kill all of those people and we're just going to sit back and let that happen.
It's their belief and we can't interfere.
It is a sun. It's not a wormhole. It's not a trans-dimensional gateway with the Garden of Eden sitting on the other side. It is a burning star that is going to vaporize 12 innocent people and one whack job.
That is enough! You are a Starfleet officer, and on this ship, I expect you to uphold the values that govern this crew. I sympathize with your thoughts and feelings, I really do. But I also have to respect the belief system of another culture. Do you understand me?
Yes, sir.
Dismissed.
she could live.
But 430 others will die.
There has to be another way.
I can't tell you what to do. But you alone know the navigational coordinates and have the piloting skill necessary to save the ship.
I don't care who dies. She lives. Not this time, Mr. Spock.
Father! I can't let you do this!
Alana!
Even if Mr. Spock is right and I survive, what kind of life would that be? How can I go back to that empty world? How can I live knowing that you, or that all of you died because of me? I don't know if there's an afterlife. I don't know where we go when we die. But a father, it's not how long we live. It's how we live that matters. Let my life mean something. These are actors, as I foretold you. We're all spirits that are melted into air. Into thin air. We are such stuff.
As dreams are made up.
I've been watching you. There you are. Come on. You're a colonel. I know you are. Listen, you can help me get out of this place. I know you.
Don't be cruel to me.
Don't worry about that guy. He's been here forever. He thinks he's Elvis.
I hate that guy.
You know I've never been one to give up a well-earned grudge. Easily.
It was a new ship. They said she was tough. I want to see what she could take.
After the Battle of Cygnus 3, our ship captain started giving the Federation its due as a worthy adversary. And for the first time, we took notice of Garth of Izar.
It was a Klingon that gave me that name. I guess there are a lot worse things that a Klingon could call you.
Yeah, sure, I'll tell you. They called me Queen Bitch Whore of the Federation.
The Ares class had withstood its first trial by fire and passed through the gauntlet victorious.
The Ares had proven itself, and it continued to prove itself. It was bigger, faster, more agile, drip drop. And it was better armed than anything we'd had before.
We had lost the advantage.
At the time, Starfleet crews preferred to fight among their own kind.
Crews might be Andorian or Tellarite or Vulcan or human. Each of which had their own strategy and tactics.
One never knew who you were fighting. And knowing one's enemy is the first rule of war. with the launch of their newer ships and the experience their commanders had gained, our progress was slowed. It was frustrating to fight Starfleet.
It was the Clapons who gave me my nickname, Vesta Vizod.
My nickname? Princess Buttercup. Those Clapon.
They call me Candyman.
After 2 years of constant defeats, the conflagration was losing confidence in Starfleet's commander-in-chief.
He was a chicken.
In quick order, Scaredy was removed, and Admiral Makus Remembers was named as his replacement. People tell me they are afraid of the Clapons. Well, I tell you, I do not fear them. I fear snakes and icky spiders. And I wet myself once when a cat jumped out of a trash can in a low-budget horror movie. But I do not fear the Clapon Empire. What are you doing?
These metals are diamond-shaped and infringe on our copyright.
You can't do that. I'm trying to give a speech here.
Free speech doesn't interest us, pal. I'm gonna need the uniform, too.
Admiral Remember's speech was certainly memorable.
Mostly because he was naked. You don't forget something like that. I've tried.
I tell you, today we will make our stand. We will fight for what's right. We will not let huge empires take away the things we hold dear.
Bring in the trucks!
Until Remember's speech, I, like everyone else, assumed the conflagration had no chance.
Excuse us, buddy. We got a C&D for your ear tips.
You've got a what? Ow! Ow!
The first thing Remembers did was begin building a new ship that could take on the Clapons.
It was the Airy class, and I was anxious to see what it could do.
The Clapon Empire was not prepared for this. I had... No, I won't remove my clothes. It's ours! The Airy class was the first real warship the conflagration had ever built.
We bought it at auction! But I have the receipt from Sotheby's.
Axed We Are was at the center of conflagration space, and it would be the location of the ultimate battle of the 4 years bore.
Infringement purged. Good luck with your movie.
Well,